Yo, what's up? This is Patrick from Guy in the Cube, and I was working with a lady building the Power BI report, and she created this table, and she drug the employee name there, and she was kind of looking through them. She was like, I know I have multiple employees with the same name. Can we show multiple employees with the same name in a visual in Power BI? And I was like, of course you can. Stay tuned. If you find this for the very first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date from all the videos from both Adam and this guy. So working with this lady, we're building this beautiful Power BI report. She's just a genius when it comes to designing these reports. And she said, hey, I know we have multiple employees here. I don't know why they're not showing up. I go, well, because they have the same name. By default, Power BI is gonna aggregate them up, distinct them out, and put them in one row or one bar, whatever the visual is. She's like, well, I need it to behave differently. I was like, all right, I'm gonna show you three ways that you can accomplish this. So you guys know how I like to do. Instead of all this talking, let's do what? Let's head over to my laptop. So let's say we had a report that looked like this. We're gonna use this email search, and you can see I have three employees. You know, all names start with Muhammad, and coincidentally, they all have the same last name. So if I click one, you'll see perfect. That's the first one. Now pay attention to these numbers. They're gonna increment a little bit. So if I choose the next one, the increment, but I don't get another Muhammad. If I click again, I don't get another Muhammad. I need to see all three of them on three different rows. You would need to add a unique identifier, kind of like a surrogate key or a primary key, a column that uniquely identifies each row. Let me show you. So what you do is expand out the customer table. Make sure you select the table first. Grab the customer key or the visual and drop it. And now you can see there's all three. If I uncheck one, check another, you can see both of them. She's like, that's cool and that will work, but I don't want to see customer name and employee key in two separate columns. You know, can we put them in one column? I was like, yeah, we can create this in the source. You can do it in Power Query. And as a last resort, you do it in DAX. Let me show you what I'm talking about. You can see I created this column called customer name and customer key. So let's select the table and get rid of customer key and customer name. And you'll see that this column contains them both and it works, right? I select, unselect. So the first one is just add the row identifier to the visual. She wasn't too happy about that. I said, let's make a concatenated column, a column that concatenates the name and the key into one column. She's like, that'll work, but won't cover all my scenarios. What if I just want to see the name without the key? If I have my little search field, I know that person's email address, I type it in and I just want to select and see that person. And maybe I know two of them. How can I get them both to show up? Let me show you. Let's just start from scratch. And I'm going to get rid of this crazy column here. And then we'll head over to the diagram view. And what I'm going to do is select this table. If the properties pane isn't expanded, go ahead and expand it and then expand the general section. And then you'll see two properties here, one for row label and one for key column. So the key column is the column that has unique values. It's going to be unique in every row. In my case, it's the customer key. It's a surrogate key in my data warehouse. You choose whatever key that is for you. And then the row label would be the name. Not in all cases, but in most cases, it would be the name. So if I choose customer name, and then if you go and expand that table, you'll know some little cards have been added to the left. So then I head back over to the report view, click it, and I'm just going to add customer name back. And then I'm going to choose this Muhammad, and then I'm going to choose that one, and then I'm going to choose that one. Look at there. They're all there. Now, which is which? I don't know. Maybe they're smart enough to know by the values that are being displayed or something like that. But now I have all three of them displayed in my table. All right. What do you guys think? Have you solved this a different way? Did you even know about those properties? If you're an old school Tabular AS guy like me, you did. All right. What do you guys think? Solve this a different way? Did you know about these properties? Do you have any questions, comments? Let's continue the conversation where? In the comments below. Your first time visiting the Guy in the Cube channel, hit that subscribe button. If you like my video, big thumbs up. As always, from Adam and myself, thanks for watching. See you in the next video.